South Australia's COVID-ready plan outlines the safe easing of restrictions and how COVID-19 will be managed in South Australia going forward. This includes opening our state borders once we reach a vaccination rate of 80% for people 16 years and over. To do this as safely as possible, we've undertaken specialist mathematical modelling to inform our hospital and public health requirements. This modelling was commissioned by SA Health in partnership with SAHMRI. It will be ongoing and is being undertaken by a team at the University of Adelaide. The team who are doing the modelling are highly expert independent academics who are part of the broader Doherty Network, which has been undertaking modelling for the Commonwealth Government. The modelling is specific to South Australia and takes into account local population factors such as our age profile, our vaccination rates across different age groups, our testing and contact tracing capacity, and of course our health system. It uses the latest science on the disease along with the impact of vaccination on the population transmission risk here in SA with our current public health restrictions. The modelling has been undertaken with various inputs, adjusting to what is most realistic for our public health capacity. Now, the model focuses on three scenarios. Each scenario relates to opening our borders and letting fully vaccinated people come into our state from the 23rd of November, and this is the date we expect to reach 80% double dose vaccinated. The modelling predicts the likelihood of an outbreak occurring, approximately when it might occur, and the size of the outbreak and how it will impact our health system. The first scenario considers opening our borders and retaining our current public health restrictions. Under this scenario, there is a 27% chance of an outbreak. For the purpose of this model, an outbreak was defined as averaging more than 100 cases per day over any 3-day period. And under this scenario, if an outbreak did occur, it's estimated that SA would be able to manage the hospital and ICU demands from COVID infections generated in the community as long as we still had high testing rates, contact tracing is maintained, and cases and their contacts are quarantined. The second scenario that we looked at considered retaining our current restrictions but getting rid of having to wear masks. The chance of an outbreak increased to 64%. And in this scenario, if the outbreak occurred, the predicted risk managing our cases, particularly for ICU, overwhelmed our capacity. The final scenario considered relaxing current restrictions by introducing the use of vaccine certificates, which would allow high risk activities by double vaccinated people. But under this scenario, there's an 84% chance of a significant outbreak. And this outbreak, there was a significant risk of not being able to manage the amount of cases in our hospital system, including hospital and ICU capacity. With this last scenario, there were also predicted to be quite a high number of deaths, which otherwise we could have avoided. South Australia is in a very fortunate position of being able to take a well-planned pathway into our next phase. The first scenario gives us the greatest opportunity to safely manage the inevitable cases of COVID in our community, accounting for the fact that all modelling has some uncertainty, and that uncertainty is because of human behaviour. Modelling will be continued on a regular basis, and the accuracy of the predictions of the model will increase over time because the actual cases we have in SA will be put into the model. This ongoing work will be very important to inform the best way forward for us in SA once we reach even higher vaccination rates, 90% and above. I would really like to thank all South Australians for your efforts so far in keeping our state safe, for getting yourself vaccinated to protect yourself, your loved ones, and our community, for getting a COVID test whenever you've got symptoms and staying home when you're sick, keeping that physical distancing from other people when you're out and about, and of course, wearing those masks. And last of all, thank you so much for continuing to wash your hands. Thank you.